गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक इनटू द अनदर सेशन ऑफ CS02 प्रॉब्लम सॉल्विंग मेथोडोलॉजीज यूजिंग प्रोग्रामिंग इन सी। लास्टली वी हैव डिस्कस्ड अबाउट द थियोरेटिकल पोर्शन ऑफ एग्जिट लेवल कंट्रोल स्टेटमेंट डू व्हाइल, वेयर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द डेफिनेशन ऑफ एग्जिट लेवल कंट्रोल स्टेटमेंट। देन वी हैव गो फॉर सिंटैक्टिकल पार्ट ऑफ एग्जिट लेवल कंट्रोल स्टेटमेंट। Then we have discussed about the details of exit level control statement, and then we have taken few example which demonstrate that how to practically handle exit level control statement called do while. Before going ahead, just have a look at the syntactical part of exit level control statement, that is do while, which I have displayed onto the screen, where first we need to write the do statement with curly brackets, contains the body of the program. Then at last there is a keyword called while, into the brackets there is a condition which is completed by the semicolon, which is must. Now last program that we have done is write a program to accept a number from user and find out the factorial of that particular number, that we have done in our previous lecture. Now we are moving ahead for the next program. The next program is write a program to print numbers, write a program to print reverse of the number. That means, suppose I am entering the number like this. Say for example my number is 123, then the output would be 321. That is called as reverse of the number. I am taking another example. Say for example my number is 431, then output would be 134. In this way we need to perform the program for reversing the number. So let's see how can we write this particular program using do while statement. So for that we are going inside the compiler of C. Then here I am writing the definition of program, that is write a program to print reverse of the number. Then inside the structure of C I am start writing the code. For that here I am initializing the first variable called I with the inbuilt function called clrscr. Then there is a message printf, enter your number. Once the message is there, we need to accept our number from the user. For that I am writing scanf%d %n. N is the number which is accepted by the program, so next variable is n. Then there is a do statement with curly brackets where I have to find out the last number of the entered digit. That means, say for example how this program works, let me clear the logic. This is the inputted number and this is the outputted number. How it works? First of all I have to find out the last value from this entire number, that is 0. Then I have to print it at the first position. Then from the existing number I have to remove the last number. Then again I have to go for searching the last number. Second time I will find it 5, I have to print it onto the screen. Then 5 will be removed from the original number. Then the last number print I have to print as it is onto the screen, that is 4. Ultimately it gives the reverse of a number. So let's see how can we design this particular program using the logical part. So let's go back into the program and temp equals to n modulo 10. Here I have to declare one variable called temp also. Then I am printing. I will tell you that how this temp works later on. Let me check first printf temp, then n divide by equals to 10. I am removing the last value. Let me save this code first. Then over here I am checking while n greater than 0. Here in this program there is no need to declare the variable called I, so I am just removing it. Let's check, will it work or not? There are no syntactical error. Let me execute this code, and I am entering the number called 379. The output should be 973. It's there. So reverse is successfully working in this particular program. Let me give the proper message over here. Reverse of the number. Let's try another entry 195. The output will be 591, but it's in a, I think I have written into the loop. That's why, okay, sorry. No need to write the message because it creates multiple messages onto the screen. Otherwise, the logic is perfect. 184481. It's a reverse of the number, so it's working properly onto the into the program. Now let's see how it works. For that, I am just debugging the code. First of all, it will accept a one value from the user. Suppose I am entering 1, 8, and 5. So this temp equals to n modulo 10 will find out the last value of the entire number. That is, the last value of this entire number is 5. So 5 will be printed, will be searched, and it will be printed onto the screen. Now 5 will be removed from the original number. Then the original number becomes 18. 18 is obviously greater than 0. Again it search for the last value. 8 will be searched out by this particular logic. Now 8 will be printed. 8 is removed. Last one is 1. 1 is searched, 1 is printed, 1 is removed, 1 is greater than 0. So it prints 581 as a reverse number onto the screen. Now let's see this particular program over the notepad for better visibility. This program is very important for university point of view. Let me go inside C drive. Turbo C, disk, bin, and 2.c. Let me open this code. This is the code. Here, say for example, I have entered 185. This is the number. Now, what is the purpose of this particular line? It will find out the last value from the entered digit, that is 5. Then 5 will be printed onto the screen. Then 5 is removed from the original number. So original number becomes 18 only. Let me write over here for clarity of execution. Now we have 18 only. This 18 is actually n, right? So this 18 is greater than 0. The loop repeats. Over here it find out the last digit from this 18. So it would came as a 8 instead of 5. 8 is printed onto the screen. 5 is already there. 8 is printed onto the screen. 8 is removed from the list. Lastly, it becomes 1. Obviously, 1 is greater than 0. Loop repeats. Here it will search for the last value, that is 1. 1 is printed over here. 1 is removed from the list. It becomes 0. That means n becomes 0. Now, 0 is not greater than 0, so this loop terminates. Finally, we'll get the output, that is 5, 8 and 1. It is actually the reverse number of this particular original entered number. So in this way this program works. I hope all of you got the logic about how to reverse the number using do while loop. So students, this is very important for university point of view. Just keep in your mind that you need to write such type of programs in practical exam as well as university theory exam. Now let's go for another program. Next one is write a program to accept one number from user and display sum of all its digits. Now what we have to do in this program, it's similar like this. First of all, I have to enter a one number from the user. Say for example, user have entered this number called 185. Then my program should perform this addition 1 plus 8 plus 5. Whatever the output of this 1 plus 8 plus 5 will be printed onto the screen. That is 8 plus 1 9 10 11 30 40 and 50. So output will be 15 onto the screen. 14 will be there onto the screen. So let's see how can we do this particular program. To make this particular program, this logic should requires, that means write a program to print sum of all digits onto the screen, right? Here I am entering one digit. It will find out the last digit, but instead of printing this last digit, here I have to change the logic, like sum equals to sum plus temp. And here one more variable should be declared, that is sum equals to 0. Then loop repeats and a last number will be searched. It will be added into the sum. It's perfect. And after this looping control statement, over here I have to write in printf percentage d sum. Let's check the code. Suppose I am entering the value called 185. The output is 14, as we have discussed into the notepad. So here I am giving the message sum ...185, and the sum is 14. Now say for example I am entering 3 times 2, then the output will be 2 plus 2 plus 2, that is 2 plus 2 4, 4 plus 2 6. So this program works perfectly into the C. Now let's see this particular program properly in notepad. C drive, disk, turbo C, bin. This is the code. Here multiple variables are declared, like n, temp and sum equals to 0. First it will accept a one number from the user. Suppose that number is 185, right? So that 185 is stored inside the variable called n. Then there is a temp equals to n modulo 10. This particular find out the last digit of entered number. That means 5 is finding by this particular logic, and it stores inside this 5 stores inside temp. Now there is a line, sum equals to sum plus temp. Value of sum for the first time is 0. So over here the execution done is 0 plus 5. Whatever the value of 0 plus 5, it is stored inside the sum, which is 5. Then last value is removed from the entire list. So this 5 is removed from the entire list. It becomes 18 only. Now this 18 is obviously greater than 0. Loop repeats. This will find out the last value called 8. Now over here value of sum is 5 plus 8 will be done. That becomes 30. Value of sum becomes 30. Last digit from the entered number will be removed. That is 8 is removed. Remaining is 1. 1 is obviously greater than 0. Loop repeats. It find out the last value. That is 1 now. 1 is stored inside the temp. Now in sum, the last value is 13, as you can see onto the screen, plus searched value is 1, which becomes 40. Now this will remove the last value. That is 1 is removed from the entire list of n. Here I have written n divided by equals to 10, which is removes the last value. Now it becomes 0. Now 0 is not greater than 0, so this repetition will not repeat, and it will print the last value of sum onto the screen, and that means 14 will be printed onto the screen. So in this way, this entire program works. I hope all of you have a very clear cut idea about this program, that how it search the digits and then it will add all the digits with each other and print onto the screen. Now let's continue with some another discussion. So these are the few exercises which you have to do by yourself. Write a program to accept one number from user and find out its and check that it's Armstrong or not. I have to give the idea for this. This is the definition. Write a program to accept one number from user and find out that it is Armstrong or not. Armstrong. Which one is the Armstrong? 143, I think, is the Armstrong number. I've forgotten. Let me check by Google. So I forgot that word. Which one is the Armstrong number? Is actually an Armstrong number. How this 153 is Armstrong number? Let me show you. First, find out every digit of this number separately. Right? So I get 1, 5, and 3. Now multiply with its own number 3 times. Multiply the number 3 times. That means 1 multiply by 3 times, 5 multiply by 3 times, and 3 multiply by 3 times. What is the output of this? Obviously 1. And output of this is 5 into 5 into 5, I think 125. 5 into 5 into 5. Yes, it's 125, and output of this is 3 into 3 into 3, it's 27. Now add all these things. That means 1 plus 125 plus 27. What will be the output of this? It's 153. Now the entered number, and after performing this operation, the output number, if both are same, then that number is what? Armstrong number. એટલે કે એન્ટર કરેલો નંબર અને આ પ્રોસેસ કર્યા પછી જે આઉટપુટ આવે છે એ બે નંબર સેમ હોય તો એ નંબરને આર્મસ્ટ્રોંગ નંબર કહેવાય. આપણે બીજો એક નંબર એન્ટર કરીને ટ્રાય કરીએ. આ લોજિક જે છે એ હું એઝ ઇટ ઇઝ રાખું છું. બીજો એક નંબર રાખું છું, સે ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ 657. આપણે ચેક કરીએ કે 657 આર્મસ્ટ્રોંગ છે કે નહીં. તો પહેલાં તો 6 પછી 5 અને 7 આ ત્રણેયને આપણે અલગ કરીએ. કર્યા અલગ. હવે 6ને 3 ટાઈમ્સ મલ્ટીપ્લાય કરીએ, 5ને પણ 3 ટાઈમ્સ મલ્ટીપ્લાય કરીએ, 7ને પણ 3 ટાઈમ્સ મલ્ટીપ્લાય કરીએ. ઉપરની જેમ જ હું પ્રોસેસ કરું છું. 6ને તમે 3 ટાઈમ્સ મલ્ટીપ્લાય કરો તો 6 × 6 × 6 આપણને મળશે 216. પછી 5ને તમે 3 વાર મલ્ટીપ્લાય કરો તો આપણને મળશે 125. અને 7ને તમે 3 ટાઈમ્સ મલ્ટીપ્લાય કરશો તો આપણને મળશે 343. હવે 216 પ્લસ 125 પ્લસ 343 એટલે કે આ આપણે ઓપરેશન કરીએ તો આનો આન્સર આપણને કેટલો મળે છે? 343 પ્લસ 125 પ્લસ 216 684 આ આન્સર મળ્યો. તો આ 684 અને એન્ટર કરેલો નંબર છે જે 657 એ બે મેચ નથી થતા. તો આ જે 657 છે ઇટ્સ નોટ એન આર્મસ્ટ્રોંગ નંબર. ઇટ્સ નોટ એન આર્મસ્ટ્રોંગ નંબર, રાઈટ? આવી રીતના તમે ઘણા બધા મિસેલિનિયસ નંબર્સ એન્ટર કરીને પણ જોઈ શકો છો. તો આનું લોજિક છે એ તમારે ઇમ્પ્લિમેન્ટ કરવાનું થાય આર્મસ્ટ્રોંગ નંબર માટે. જે ડેફિનેશન મેં તમને અહીંયા આપેલી છે, રાઇટ એ પ્રોગ્રામ ટુ એક્સેપ્ટ વન નંબર ફ્રોમ યુઝર એન્ડ ફાઇન્ડ આઉટ દેટ ઇટ ઇઝ આર્મસ્ટ્રોંગ ઓર નોટ. સેકન્ડ ઇઝ, આ સ્કીપ કરી દેજો, આ અત્યારે નથી કરવી, પ્રાઇમ ઓર નોટ. નેક્સ્ટ ઇઝ રાઇટ એ પ્રોગ્રામ ફોર ફાઇન્ડિંગ આઉટ 1 ફેક્ટોરિયલ પ્લસ 2 ફેક્ટોરિયલ પ્લસ 3 ફેક્ટોરિયલ પ્લસ 4 ફેક્ટોરિયલ પ્લસ 5 ફેક્ટોરિયલ અપ ટુ એન ટર્મ્સ. નાવ હાઉ ઇટ વર્ક્સ, સૌથી પહેલાં તો ફેક્ટોરિયલ ફાઇન્ડ આઉટ કરવા માટેનો પ્રોગ્રામ આપણે લખેલો છે. સે ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ આઈ એમ એન્ટરિંગ 5, વોટ વિલ બી ધ ફેક્ટોરિયલ ઓફ 5? દેટ ઇઝ 5 × 4 × 3 × 2 × 1. વોટ એવર ધ આઉટપુટ કેમ્સ ઓન ટુ ધ સ્ક્રીન, ઇટ્સ અ ફેક્ટોરિયલ ઓફ ધ નંબર, રાઈટ? સો વોટ આઈ હેવ ટુ ડુ ફોર ધીસ પર્ટિક્યુલર પ્રોગ્રામ 1 ફેક્ટોરિયલ પ્લસ 2 ફેક્ટોરિયલ? સે ફોર એક્ઝામ્પલ હિયર આઈ એમ જસ્ટ રાઇટિંગ 1 2 3 4 5. I don't want to go for n, I just want to go for 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. What is the factorial of 1? 1 into 1, that is 1. Then the factorial of 2 is 2 into 1. Factorial of 3 is 3 into 2 into 1. Factorial of 4 is 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Then factorial of 5 is 5 into 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. Value of this is obviously 1. Value of this 2 is 2. Value of this one is 6. Value of this one is 4 into 3 12, 12 into 2 24. And the value of this one is 5 into 4 4 into 3 into 2 into 1. It's 120. Right? So this would be the final number. Now what I have to do? I want to add all these numbers. That is 120 plus 24 plus 6 plus 2 plus 1. So the output would be 120 plus 24 plus 6 plus 2 plus 1. It's 153. So the factorial of this number, sum of factorial of this number is 153. This would be the logic for finding out the factorial of number for n terms. Right? Next is, write a program to check whether the given number is palindrome or not. Now, what is palindrome? Say, for example, I am entering one text, that is madam. If I reverse this particular string, my last is M, then A, then D, then A, and then M. My forward and reverse, if both are same, then this particular text is called as what? Palindrome text. Say, for example, I am writing sir, and I am reversing this sir as a R, I, S. Is it same? Both are same? No, both are not same. So this string is not palindrome. So you have to implement a logic for checking that the string is palindrome or not. Then next one is, write a program to find numbers between 1 to 100 that are divisible by 3 and 7. That means in between the numbers called 1 to 100, whatever the numbers are, that like 1, 2, 3, so on, up to 100. Which are the numbers that is divisible by 3 and 7? We have to search that particular numbers and then print that numbers onto the screen. Say, for example, in between this 1 is not divisible by 3 or 7, 2 is not divisible by 3 or 7, 3 is divisible by 3, so 3 will be printed onto the screen, 4 will not printable onto the screen, 5, 6 is also divisible by 3, so 6 will be printed, and so on, up to 100. Which are the numbers is divisible by 3 and 7 should be printed onto the screen, that we have to do in this particular program. I am just keeping this particular slide for few seconds onto the screen. Just note down every definition properly. Try to implement by yourself, and once you successfully implement all this definition by your own into the computer or mobile, just write down into the journals. Don't worry about saving the programs. Once you write this particular program into the journal, it's okay. So I am just keeping this particular slide for the few seconds. Note down every definition properly. I hope all of you have written all these definitions properly. Just implement this and then note down into the journals. Now, in next lecture, we'll go for another type of looping control structure, which is very important for university examination and for the entire career, that is for loop. But we'll discuss this particular looping control statement in next lecture. Thank you very much, students, for listening to me, and have a nice day.